Welcome back to Tampa Bay's Morning Blend. You know, the school year may look different for a lot of families this year, but there is one thing that will not change. In fact, we may see that there's just even a bigger need for this, and it's mentors. And there is a great program. Maybe you've heard of it before, maybe you haven't, but it's in Pinellas County, and it's called Lunch Pals. And our next guest here is joining us, Ron Diner, here this morning to tell us about how you can become a Lunch Pal, and again, why now it may be more important than ever to make sure students have a mentor. Good morning. So good to see you, Ron.
Good morning. Thank you.
I love the idea of this. And again, I know that it's going to be a little different this year, but again, the need for it is still there, if not stronger. Tell us a little bit about the Lunch Pals program.
Well, again, as you mentioned, Lunch Pals is all about being a pal with a kid who needs us most. And this year in particular, we're focusing not only on the children that need us most, but the schools who need us most. And it's all about being a friend to a child who could use a friend. It's being making an impact for these children and being inspired by the changes that you can make. And it's now this year easier than ever because you can mentor from anywhere. And it's only
30
minutes.
So yeah, we're looking at video. I'd imagine this is from last year when it's actually, you know, in school. But now this year it's going to be all virtual, correct?
Yeah. Well, at least for a while, it's going to be all virtual. And but the idea is the same. You get one person who wants to participate gets matched up with a child. Primarily, we're focused on elementary schools, and we are focused primarily this year on the schools that have the highest degree of poverty because their schools have the most number of kids who really could benefit from a caring adult. But you get matched up, and then it's a virtual lunch once a week for 30 minutes with
a child.
So
the schools actually have a space where they can kind of go separately and have this virtual meeting. So, here's my thought, my question for you, if, as an adult and someone, okay, I'm ready to mentor, and you think, well, I don't know, what do I have to offer? Who would make a good mentor? Who are those adults that could be a good inspiration for these kids?
Well, the question you're asking is a frequently asked question. Yeah. And the answer to the question really is anyone could be a good mentor, because the key to being a good lunch pal is really just being there for your student and being a good listener. As my wife, who was a social worker in the school system for many years, told me when I first got started with this, it's all about showing up, because these are kids who don't have someone who cares enough to show up on a regular basis. And this year in particular, working with Pinellas County Schools, the school system is working on some really neat ideas whereby once a week for each week, we're going to have a curriculum of ideas and topics and things that you can talk about with your child every single week. So even though you might not know, what do I do? First of all, you just show up and be a friend and listen. And then on top of it, there's going to be lots of information available as to what you might want to talk about with your student.
Can you share a little bit on the reactions from students? And again, because I may be thinking, I don't know, is a kid going to want to meet a stranger? You know, I mean, kind of visit with somebody. What is the reaction and the response that you've heard from students who partake in this program?
Well, first of all, we've been at this about 6 or 7 years. What happened was about, I think it was 7 years ago, I met with the principal of an elementary school in St. Petersburg, Mount Vernon Elementary. And she explained to me the great need among these children to have somebody who would come and have lunch. And so we've been surveying since then, the kids, the parents, the teachers, the principals, asking them how, two things, you know, what the impact, how much of an impact they think they've had. And the responses have been overwhelmingly positive in terms of what impact it has. And not only that, but there's also all kinds of data out there on mentoring and how much the value of mentoring is. And as Oprah says, you know, just about nobody makes it alone. And I can tell you in my own instance that when I started, I could tell you a story about a kid who was living in a group home, and he had great challenges in his life, but after a few weeks of having a lunch with me, all of a sudden we were reading books and he was putting his arm around me. So I knew I was having an impact on that little boy. And since then, I've been having lunch with two other boys, not at the same time, starting in second and third grade, and they're going into eighth grade. And when I asked, and I just to mention one other thing in terms of the impact, when I asked one of them, I said, what do you like about having lunch with me? And he says, I just like to hang out.
Oh, isn't that what it boils down to? I have two elementary age kids. I get it. And I think this is a wonderful program. There is the website where people can learn about volunteering and getting involved, correct?
That is correct. Go right there. There's lots of information. You can sign up, go attend a virtual workshop, and we'll hook you up with the child. School starts in a few weeks, and lunch pails will start a few weeks after that, we hope.
Ron, thank you so much. We appreciate all that you're doing.
Thank you for having me.